Hello everyone, let's get started with the next session on transmission and distribution module 2. So I'm Gautaman, associate professor, department of EEE, Vidyavardhaka College of Engineering, Mysuru. So the learning objectives of this particular section are, so at the end of the session, you will be able to determine the capacitance for three phase double circuit lines considering symmetrical and asymmetrical spacing. The last session was on single circuit lines. So you already know about double circuit and single circuit lines when I explained the concepts pertaining to determination of inductance. So in this session, it is a double circuit line considering symmetrical and asymmetrical spacing, but you will be able to determine the capacitance of such lines. I've also explained the major difference between single circuit and double circuit lines. So the major difference between single circuit and double circuit lines is you will be able to it is how the conductors are spaced and conductors are considered in a line. That is the actual difference between a single circuit and double circuit lines. And at last, we will be solving some simple problems to determine the capacitance in a single phase and three phase lines. Okay, so let's get started with it. So first thing is you need single three phase double circuit lines are considered over here with symmetrical spacing. So over here it is your conductors has to be placed at the vertices of a hexagon, each having a side of d meters. Okay, so this is the hexagonal structure of representing a transmission line. So here it is a double circuit line and the conductors are placed at the corners of a hexagon and they're spaced and at the side of each the distance over here is d meters. So conductors x, y and z belong to one circuit. And the y dash and z dash belong to the second circuit because over here we have considered a double circuit lines. So x, y, z belong to one circuit and x dash, y dash and z dash belong to the other circuit. So this is the distance of whatever that we have considered. If you know the determination of inductance of a double circuit line, it is the same way of how we have considered the distance over here. Over here, you need to consider it's like how you calculate the values of altitude in a trigonometric function for a normal triangle. Similar way, you need to consider that, and this will be the value of the distance dxz is root 3d, and dxy is d. And x to x dash is the distance between x to x dash is 2 times d. Okay, it's like so x to x dash is this, x to x dash is if this is d, this has to be 2d. Okay, this is how you need to consider the particular. If you want to know x, y, you have root 3d over here, and this value is d. This center point, this value is d. You can easily find out the value of x, y. Okay, if you are well versed with finding the unknown of a triangle in a trigonometry, it's a similar way of finding the value of the unknown distance here. So as we used to consider in most of our derivations, the sum of charges in all the three phases you need to consider it as zero. Sum of charges in all the three phases need to be considered as zero. That is qx plus qy plus qz, you are equating it to zero. Radius of each conductor is considered as r, like how we have seen this in the previous derivation. If you just look into lecture 4, you will get an idea of it. And the general expression for a potential difference between two phases, x and y, with respect to position 1, like how we derive the expression for this in the last session, that is in lecture 4, you'll get an idea. That is used as reference in order to write this expression. So similarly here, you need to find out the value of potential difference between phase x and y, position 1, due to the considering all the charges on conductors x, y and z. So what will be its value? So its value will be this. Vx1 is equal to Qx divided by 2 pi epsilon naught ln d by r. And since the next part is Qy, since charges are opposite, it will have a negative sign. That is shown as ln r by d. If you have to write, yeah, that is denotes it is negative, it is opposite. And again, the charge on conductor Z is Qz. It's the distance over here. The distance is usually d divided by r. But what is this r over here? It's nothing but the distance. Because it is a double circuit line, its value will be root 3 times t. So on simplification, you get it as the Qx value is brought inside. So 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught Qx ln d by r. So Qy is also brought inside here and Qz. So this is a simplified expression and this is denoted as equation 1. So now we will move on to the next one. The similar grounds, if you just consider the potential difference between two phases x and y with respect to position 2, what will be its value? Okay. And again, you need to consider the charges on the conductors x dash, y dash, and z dash. So this will be the expression. So only distance over, since it is a double circuit line, you don't have r here, the value gets changed. Okay, the position values gets changed. You need to know that general position and you should start applying what would be its value. Similarly, a d is replaced, d by r is replaced by root 3 times d divided by 2 times d. So if you know, if you have listened to the latest 4th session on inductance, how we found out, is the similar manner you are supposed to find out the distance between the two conductors. It can be either x, y, x dash, y dash, or x, x, x dash, so on and so forth. Okay, on simplification, again, how we simplify, we brought the Qx inside. Similarly, here Qx is taken inside and it is simplified and that equation over here is considered as equation 2. So using both equations 1 and 2, we are supposed to find out the total potential difference between phase X and Y due to the charges on conductors of first and second circuit. What are the conduct charges that you have on conductors? Charges on conductors, first conductor, that is x, y, z and x dash, y dash, z dash, you're supposed to find out the net potential difference. So we will sum up Vx, y, the net is potential difference is equal to potential difference in position 1 and potential difference in position 2. So this is the first part wherein you get potential difference because of position 1. This is the other part wherein you get the potential difference of position 2. You need to sum it up. After you equate it, so this will be the equation that is obtained. That is 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught Qx ln root 3 times d divided by 2 times r plus Qy ln 2r divided by root 3 times d plus Qz ln 1. On simplification, this is the expression that is obtained. So on further simplification of the previous equation, so this will be the expression that you get. That's the mathematical simplification. Similar manner, there we were able to find out the value for Vxy. Vxz can also be found in the same grounds. And its value is also the same as the previous. Both the equations are same. Expression, potential difference because of xy and potential difference with respect to xz. So both equations over here are same. So now here it's nothing but Vxy plus Vxz is nothing but 3 times of Vxn, whatever that we had found out previously. So when you add it, it is the 3 times of voltage of a phase X or a conductor X with respect to neutral. So when you add a potential difference Vxy and potential difference Vxz, it is nothing but the 3 times the value of a particular conductor or a phase with respect to neutral. So how do we obtain this? So again, you are adding here. You are adding. So addition of two expressions on simplification. So you will just see the like terms and add them. So you get 2 times Qx and Qy and Qz are similar. So you are again adding them and you're grouping them to the other side. So that it will be easy for us to simplify further. So you also know that Qy plus qz, whatever that in the previous equation is nothing but minus qx, because you know you have sum up all the charges on the conductors, that is qx plus qy plus qz is equal to zero. So what is the value of qy plus qz over here? It's nothing but minus qx. So on substituting this to the previous equation, so this will be the value of expression that we can get. That is, this is the potential difference of conductor x or a phase x with respect to neutral. So now we are supposed to, what were our intention in the beginning? Because we are in the intention in the beginning was to find out the capacitance with respect to of a particular conductor x with respect to neutral. Capacitance, you know, it's nothing but the charge divided by potential difference. So charge is qx, because you are finding capacitance of conductor x with respect to neutral, so you are supposed to consider the charge with respect to q, with respect to x, that is qx divided by vxn. On simplification, so this will be the final expression, that is 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln root 3 times d divided by 2 farads per meter. So what will be the capacitance per phase, its value? So it will be per phase, will be the value of that will be 2 times of a capacitance of a particular conductor with respect to neutral. It is 2 times Cxn. So therefore, the expression gets further changed to, since it is 2, it was just 2 pi epsilon naught, it is 4 pi epsilon naught divided by ln root 3 times d divided by 2r farads per meter, but here it is with respect to per phase. So farads per meter per phase. This expression is important wherein to solve the problems. Kindly remember this so that at the end of one more concept, we can easily find out the, we can solve few problems on this topic. So how do you apply the concept of geometric mean distance and geometric mean ratio to this? Okay, like how I explained GMD and GMR in the previous session, well, we found out the value of inductance. The concept is same. Okay, whatever the equating or the assumption that will be made is exactly same, but over here you will be finding it or applying it for the capacitance. Again, it is yet another, it is also called as another method to calculate the capacitance, especially if the lines are transposed. The concept arises in because of transposition or if the lines are transposed. So whenever, as we already mentioned, GMR is nothing but geometric mean radius, R is taken instead of R dash. And you know the value of R dash is nothing but 0.77 times R. And you also know why it is such. Why it is that? I have already gave you an example and I have explained that in my lecture 2 session. You can just look into that. Okay, the same thing, the analysis, whatever that was used to find out the value of inductance in the previous session, the same thing we will be applying over here. It's nothing but the determination of capacitance. So mutual GMD of a particular phase x or a conductor phase x is nothing but eighth root of this value. On simplification, so it gets further simplified, because on simplification is you need to substitute the values of dxy, dxz, dxy dash, dxz dash, etc., etc., like that. Like how in the beginning, when the lines are transposed, when you'll be finding what would be the value or distance calculation, substitute that, you'll get an expression. That is fourth root of root 3 times t. So this is the self GMD, which is GMR, is also called as self geometric mean distance of a particular phase. Again, on simplification of this previous expression, it's fourth root. So you will, the final expression over here will be square root of 2 times d into r, square root of 2 times d into r. So on application of this equation in the expression capacitance per phase, what will you get? So it's another 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln. The numerator becomes geometric mean distance and denominator becomes geometric mean ratio or radius, farads per meter per phase. Okay, geometric mean distance divided by geometric mean radius. So this is the final and simplified expression after you apply GMD, the concept of GMD and GMR. Else you can remember the previous equation itself in order to solve the problems. Now, the previous case was unsymmetrically spaced double circuit. The conductors were spaced symmetrically in the previous derivation. Over here, the conductors are placed unsymmetrically. It was symmetrically placed double circuit line. Over here, it's nothing but an unsymmetrically spaced double circuit three-phase line. You cannot move further if it is just unsymmetrically spaced, because the capacitance over here would differ. So that would create an unbalance. As a result, you have to transpose the lines. So transposition over here is absolutely important, especially when the lines are not properly spaced, or if it is not equilaterally spaced, or if it is not symmetrically spaced. So let's get started with this. So this is how the conductors are positioned, or it is spaced. We also know the concept over here is cyclic symmetry. The movement of conductors are they're cyclically symmetric. Okay, so we will just consider the position one over here. So in position one, you have dxy is considered as d meters, dxz1 is considered as h meters, dxy1 g meters, dxs is nothing but f meters. So if you consider mutual GMD or self GMD of a conductor x in position one, so this is the general expression you already know, you will be start substituting the values of this over here. Similarly, when you have to consider the self GMD of a particular conductor x in position two, so this will be the simplified expression. The general expression remains the same. It's fourth root of dxy dxz dxy1 dx z dash or y dash. So on simplification, this will be the value that you get: geometric mean distance for position one, geometric mean distance for position two, and geometric mean distance for position three. So what will be the geometric mean radius of this? GMR is nothing but, so its value is root of RD. Over here, it's nothing but D distance is a conductor X with respect to the distance with respect to conductor X dash. So that value is F. So it's root of RF. In the similar manner, you will be finding GMR with respect to position two. The general expression remains the same. It's root of RD X X dash. Okay. So based on the position, the dx x dash will change. In the first case, it is f. In the second case, it is h. And in the third case, it is f. What will be the value of equivalent geometric mean distance and radius? Okay, dm and ds. What will be the equivalent value? So you'll be considering it as cube root of gmd1, gmd2, and gmd3. On substituting the individual values of GMD with respect to position one, the value of GMD in position two, and value of GMD in position three. So this will be the expression. On further simplification, you will get this as the equivalent value of DM. So DS is again GMR cube root of, again on simplification, this will be the expression for DS, that is GMR. So that was the expression that This was the expression for DM, and this is the expression for DS. So how do you apply this on an equation of capacitance of phase X? How do we apply? So we will be just substituting the obtained values of DM and DS in this equation. So it gets replaced that it was just 2 pi epsilon naught ln DM by DS. So you are substituting the value of DM here, equivalent DM, and equivalent DS. On further simplification, this will be the expression 4 pi epsilon naught divided by ln 2 to the power of 1 by 3 dg g to the power of 2 by 3 divided by the denominator of rf to the power of 2 by 3 farads per meter per phase. So this will be the final expression using the value of GMD and GMR for an unsymmetrically spaced three-phase double circuit line. Let's get started with the problems now. Okay, let's get started with the problem. So you are supposed to determine the value of capacitance per phase of a three-phase transmission line that is shown in the figure. You have three conductors here, which are placed at the corners of a triangle. So the diameter of conductors over here is 3.5 centimeters, assume that the line is, you are supposed to assume that the line is transposed. Okay, with this given details. So let's get started with the first problem. So diameter of the conductors, it's already given. It is given as 3.5 centimeter. You just now we have completed capacitance of phase X to neutral expression. So let's see what is that expression. So this is the expression CXN. Capacitance of conductor X with respect to neutral is nothing but 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln D equivalent by R. So what is the value of D equivalent here? It's cube root of DXY, DYZ and DXZ. So you know the distance, DXY. The value of DXY is 6, DYZ is 3 and DXZ is 5. That is substituted in this equation. So you will get D equivalent as 4.481 meters. Okay, you will substitute this in this expression, 2 pi epsilon naught is substituted divided by ln. D equivalent is 4.481 divided by R is 0.0175. So therefore, what is the value of capacitance here? The final value of capacitance is 10 picofarads per meter. So how do you find the value of R here? You can find out the value of R using the equation. So you, okay, whatever the R dash value, can you use the equation that was given? That so you will get the value of R over here because the diameter is already given in the problem. What was the diameter that was given in the problem? It was 3.5 centimeter. Convert that into meters and later find out the radius from the given value of diameter. If you do that, you will get the value of this R. And later on simplification, you get capacitance of a conductor X with respect to neutral is nothing but 10 picofarads per meter. Let's move on to the next problem. So that previous problem was a three-phase line. Over here, we'll just consider the single-phase transmission line. So over here, a single-phase transmission line is considered. It has two parallel conductors. And these conductors are 4 meters apart, 4 meters apart. And the diameter of each conductor is 4 centimeter. Okay, the distance is 4 meters apart and the diameter of each conductor is 4 centimeter. So you are supposed to find out the value of capacitance per kilometer. Okay, you're supposed to find out the value of capacitance per kilometer. What is a given value? Diameter is given. Diameter of each conductor is given as 4 centimeter. It is also mentioned in the diagram. Diameter and distance between the two conductors X and Y is also mentioned as 4 meters. So you know the value of capacitance here. It is CXY for a single phase line is pi epsilon naught divided by ln T by R farads per meter. So you will substitute the value of epsilon naught ln D is already there 3 divided by R. You can find out the value of R by knowing the diameter. Diameter is 4, half of that is R. On further simplification, capacitance of two conductors or between 1 and 2 positions or between conductor X and Y is nothing but 5.55 picofarads per meter. It's nothing but 5.55 picofarads per meter. Okay, this is further simplified, converted. So they have asked you to find out the value of capacitance per kilometer. How do you convert it? So it's been converted. When you convert, pico becomes nanofarads per kilometer. Let's move on to the next problem now. So it's a three-phase line. So a three-phase 50 hertz 66 kV line, overhead conductors are placed in a horizontal plane. The placement is horizontal, which is as shown in the figure. The conductor diameter over here is 1.25 centimeter. The diameter is 1.25 centimeter. So you can easily calculate the radius of that since diameter is given. The line length over here is 100 kilometers. You're supposed to find capacitance per phase. That's the first thing that you're supposed to find. And you're supposed to find the charging current per phase. And you should assume the lines are completely transposed. So this is the diameter. So you have the distance between the distance between conductors is nothing but 4.5 meters. That's a total distance. Individual distance DAB is 2 meters, and the distance from B to C is 2.5 meters, and the total distance between A to C is 4.5 meters. So how do you find a capacitance of a particular conductor with respect to neutral? You know the general expression. It's 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln D by R. You are supposed to find the radius of this. So after finding the value of radius, okay, you know the general expression for D over there is nothing but D equivalent. It's nothing but root 3 cube root of DAB, DBC and DCA. Over here, since it is three phase, it will be D equivalent. Whether I write D or D equivalent, whenever you consider this expression, if it is a three phase line, it has to be ln of D equivalent by R, and that D or D equivalent is nothing but root 3 times of or cube root of DAB, DBC and DCA. Substitute the values that are given. Total is AC was 4.5, the remaining is 2 and 2.5. So when you simplify it, you will get that's 2.823 meters. What will be the capacitance of a conductor here with respect to neutral? On substitution, you will get it as 9.08 picofarads per meter. You'll get it as 9.08 picofarads per meter. So the first one, what is that you're supposed to find? You're supposed to find capacitance per phase, and they have mentioned the line length is around 100 kilometers. So how do you find it out? So capacitance per phase is already found, that is 9.08 picofarads per meter, but you're supposed to find it for 100 kilometers. So what you are supposed to multiply it by, whatever you've got CAN, multiply it by 100 kilometers, you will get it as 0.908 microfarads per meter. You will get it as 0.908 microfarads per meter. So the next one, you're supposed to find the charging current. So how do you find the charging current? You require the value of reactance, XC, capacitive reactance. It's nothing but 1 by 2 pi FC on substitution, because C you already got in the previous expression was 0.908 micro. Substitute that, F is 50. So you will get the X value as 3505.6 ohms. From this, you can easily find out the value of charging current. Expression for charging current, I is nothing but V divided by XC, but you have to consider the value of V phase. So it is 66 kV was the line voltage. So you have to convert it into phase. Therefore, you have root 3 there. Substitute the value of XC, the charging current will be 10.869 amperes. We will move on to the last problem of this particular session. Here you have considered a three-phase, a given problem is a three-phase line circuit, so which is consisting of three conductors. Diameter of each conductor is 30 millimeters, and the spacing between the conductor is XY is 3.5 meters, YZ is 5 meters, ZX is 4 meters. And you are supposed to find out the capacitance and the reactance per phase per kilometer of the line. Again, over here, line is transposed. Okay. How we found out this previous problem in the similar grounds, we will see how best we can solve the problem. Diameter is given, which is nothing but 30 millimeters. So convert it into meter, because all other values are in meters. So radius, you can easily calculate, it's D by 2. There's a value 0.015 meters. Given as lines are completely transposed. So you know expression for capacitance of conductor X with respect to neutral is 2 pi epsilon naught ln D equivalent by R. Okay, whether it's D or D equivalent, it's the same because it's a three-phase line. You need to consider it like that. So you are supposed to 2 pi epsilon naught, you know the value of D equivalent is nothing but cube root of DXY, DYZ and DXZ. Substitute the values of DXY, DYZ and DXZ. Substitute it, simplify. On simplification, you will get the capacitance of conductor X with respect to neutral is 9.9 into 10 power minus 12 farad per meter. It is 9.9 picofarads per meter. So you have to supposed to convert it into kilometer, because that is what they have asked. Okay, it's nanofarad per kilometer. They have also asked capacitive reactance per phase per kilometer. It's nothing but xc, 1 by 2 pi fc. Substitute the value of c that you have got in the previous equation. Frequency is 50. Capacitive reactance value will be 3.21 kilo ohms per phase per kilometer. Okay, so this is the expression for capacitance. Okay, in a similar grounds, there are a lot of problems to find out the capacitances capacitive reactances and charging current. These are the normally asked questions in the examinations. They will ask you to find out the value of capacitance, either giving a single phase line or a three phase line, and they will ask you to find out the value of reactance, capacitive reactance, and also the charging current. You should be very careful whether they have asked you to find the value per meter or per kilometer. So if it's per kilometer, you're supposed to consider the value and simplify. Sometimes they also give you the line length, it's so and so kilometer, and you're supposed to find out the value of capacitance considering so many kilometers. That time you're supposed to multiply it by the given kilometer and simplify your answer. All these are certain changes that they would ask in the examinations. And determination of capacitances and inductance are very important for in most of the competitive examinations. Such kind of problems will be asked in most of the competitive examinations. So we will continue some more problems in the next session. And thank you.